نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد إخوتي في الله فاعلموا أن خير الكلام كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار عن أبي ذر الغفاري رضي الله عنه قال وعن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إني لأعلم آخر أهل الجنة دخول الجنة وآخر أهل النار خروجا منها رجل يؤتى به يوم القيامة فيقال اعرضوا عليه صغائر الذنوب وارفعوا عنه كبائرها فتعرض عليه صغائر الذنوب فيقال له عملت يوم كذا كذا وكذا وكذا وعملت يوم كذا كذا وكذا وكذا فيقول نعم لا يستطيع أن ينكر منها شيئا وهو مشفق من أن يعرض عليه كبائر الذنوب فيقال له إن لك بكل سيئة حسنة فيقول أي ربي إن لي أعمالا أشياء عملتها لا أراها هاهنا فيقول أبو ذر رضي الله عنه فلقد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يضحك حتى بدت نواجذه صلى الله عليه وسلم رواه مسلم. Very unique hadith. Very, very unique hadith, ikhwati fillah. Listen to the hadith. The Messenger of Allah said, and this is according to how Abu Dharr radiyallahu anhu narrated. He said, I know the last man who would enter paradise. And I know the last person who will exit from paradise. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam start talking about the first man. قال رجل يؤتى به يوم القيامة. A man that the angels of Allah will bring him forth. And the angels will receive his special orders from Allah. يقال لهم, present his minor sins to him. And hide his major sins from him. So the malaika, they will come. Now keep in mind, this individual does not know what he is about to witness. So the malaika said to this man, you did such and such on that particular day. And you did this on that day. And the man would say yes. And he would not be able to deny them because they are right in front of him. And then, while he's admitting this, he's concerned about the major sins that he did, about the lies, about the interest, about his stealing that he thinks that he stole, about major sins that he did, the zina that he committed. And he's saying to himself, all the things that they're presenting to me are minors. If this is the situation of minor sins, what would be the condition of major sins? But Allah will surprise him, or the angels will surprise him with this. They will say to him, for every sin that you commit, you receive hasana. For every sin. Now, he was dealing with minor things. Maybe you looked at your brother in the wrong way. Maybe you parked on the handicap parking spot. And you said, this is not the sunnah. Or maybe you parked on my spot. And you said, Brother Sa'id, the Prophet's camel had no special spot. And Allah is asking you because you broke the law. Minor things. And all of a sudden they tell you, for every sin that we mention, we reward you hasana for it. Not punish you, but reward you. And then the man will say, Ya Allah, wait a second. Inna li a'mal ashya. Wait a second. These are nothing. I have done. I committed zina. I stole. Where are they? Now look, subhanAllah. Now he's asking for his major sins. Why? Because he realized that now every sin that he did will turn into hasan. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave all his sins. In Surah Al-Furqan, when Allah is addressing the issue of the believers, they don't commit shirk, they don't kill innocent people, وَلَا يَزْنُونَ. And then Allah said, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابِ. Now look, whoever does all these major sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, will double his punishment. إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. For those individuals, their سيئات will turn into good deeds. Now, you and I sitting here, remembering the sins that we committed in the past, remembering the things that we did, and I'm telling you from now on, forget them. Overlook them. And I don't say commit more, but start a new page with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fresh page. Fresh page. Brand new. Don't worry what happened yesterday. Don't worry about what you did in the past. Worry about tonight, today, tomorrow, and have that positive attitude. لأن في الحاكم وصححه الألباني يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من حديث أبي هريرة ليتمنين أقوام لو أكثر من السيئات. He says certain people would wish if they committed so much evil deeds. The Sahaba said, Ya Rasulullah, bima? Why? قال يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات. Because Allah turned all the evil deeds to good deeds. To حسنات. إخوتي في الله. From now on, from today, worry about the hasanat that you should do and perform from now on. Because Allah promised you if you repent, He will not only forgive your sins, but He will turn them into hasanat. So what do you worry about? Is Allahu Akbar. I'm going to start a fresh page with Allah. I'm not going to worry, Ya Akhi, what about the statement that we should weep for our sins? Yes, you should do this. The moment that you feel proud, the moment that you say, oh, I did so many hasanat, mashallah, bring yourself to account, to an account, and say, look, you did this, and you did that, and you did this, and you cry for your sins. But now, you should start. Fresh start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He was talking about shaitan, what did He say? الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. Shaitan promises you poverty. Don't give. Don't help. No. Withhold. But Allah said, وَاللَّهُ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَمَغْفِرَةً مِنَ يَعِدُكُمْ مَغْفِرَةً مِنْهُ وَفَضْلًا مَغْفِرَةً مِنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلًا. And the promises of Allah are true. They are true. So don't ever say, what can I do, Ya Akhi? Every time I try to do righteous deeds, I go back into a ma'asiyah. Every time I say, this is the last tawbah, this is the last sin, and I repent to Allah, I find myself starting new page of ma'asi. That's because you're human, Ya Ikhwati Fillah. We're humans. That's why we're doing this. But every time you start and you say, Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised me this, therefore I will not do anything else but worry about my hasanat. Ayna. And listen, ya ikhwati fillah. A man from the sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a man who did everything. Old man. His name was Abu Tawil. شطب المندود. He can hardly walk. Very weak man. And he came and he stood in front of the messenger of Allah. فقال يا رسول الله أرأيت من عمل المحر الذنوب كلها لم يترك منها شيئا ومع ذلك لم يترك حاجة ولا داج إلا آتاها فهل له من توبة؟ He said, Ya Rasulullah, what do you think about a man who commit all different types of sins? All different types of sins. He did everything wrong. وَمَعَ ذَلِكَ وَفِي ذَلِكَ And at the top of that, he did not leave major sin or minor sin except that he committed. Is his repentance accepted? فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَأَسْلَمْتْ Did you declare the shahada? فَقَالَ أَمَّا أَنَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ فَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ أَنَّكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ All the sayyi'at that you commit, all the major sin that you did, Allah will turn them into good deeds. And the man could not believe it. فقال and he said, وقجراتي. He said, what about my major sins? What about the major and the minors? فقال نعم and those two فلا يزال يكرره حتى توارى and the man is keep repeating the statement of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم وغدراتي وفجراتي وغدراتي until he disappeared from the Sahaba. So no matter what you did in the past, are we all Muslims? Are we all Muslims? I'm asking the question. The answer is yes. Are we all fasting? The answer is yes. Do we believe in Allah? The answer is yes. Do we fear Allah? The answer is yes. Then bushra lakum. Glad tidings to all of you. Because whatever you did in the past would not matter. If you walk from this masjid, believing there's only one God, doing the righteous deeds, being concerned about your niyyah, not the size of the action in front of the people, be concerned what you have in your heart, then I guarantee you, Allah would not waste one single hasanah of your hasanat. And He will turn every ma'asiyah, every sin into hasanat. You may say, Ya ikhwati fillah, you may say to yourself, I don't feel the change. I don't feel it. It's not in me. It's not, I cannot feel it. Don't worry. It's coming. Because Rasulullah informed us, not only you, not only your heart, but Allah will change the condition of the ummah in one day because of one man. When the Mahdi comes, he will change the condition of the whole ummah in one day. And your heart can be changed. Maybe tonight is the night. Maybe tonight is when you have that appointment with Allah. And all of a sudden the tarawih that used to be long is so light. The recitation of the Quran was so difficult, is all mashallah enjoyable. The hasanat that used to struggle, mashallah, is so easy. Because that is the feeling you will get. The a'mal, the hasanat,
they will become so easy for you to perform. And the sayyi'at will become so heavy. You will worry about them before you even think about them. Just remembering them will worry you. And this is a sign of acceptance. So give yourself the opportunity. Start that page and say, no, Allah loves me. And Allah promised me if I repent to Him, He will forgive me. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا إِنَّهُ الْغَفُورُ رَحِيمُ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. في مسند أحمد, four of the companions of the Messenger of Allah sat together, and one of them said, first of the four, قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الله لا يقبل توبة العبد قبل يومه قبل موته بيوم. He say, I heard the Messenger of Allah saying that Allah will accept the repentance of the slave, of the servant, a day before his death. Second Sahabi said, أَنْتَ سَمِعْتَ هَذَا مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, you heard that from the Messenger of Allah? قَالَ نَعَمْ, yes. Then the second Sahabi said, I heard from the Messenger of Allah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبْدَ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ بِالنِّسْفَ يَوْمِ, Allah would accept the repentance of the slave half day before his death. The third Sahabi said to the second, you heard that from the Messenger of Allah? He said, yes. He said, but I heard from the Messenger of Allah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ تَوْبَةِ الْعَبْدِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ بِضَحْوَةِ, Allah would accept the repentance of the servant early part, a fraction of the day before his death. And the fourth Sahabi said, you heard that from the Messenger of Allah? He said, yes. He said, but I heard from the Messenger of Allah saying, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبْدِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرْ, Allah would accept the tawbah of the slave before the soul reaches the collarbone. Yani when the soul leaves the body and everything below this point is dead. And this is where is the soul is. That moment Allah would accept, before that, Allah would accept the tawbah. Allahu Akbar ya ikhwati fillah. Allahu Akbar. No matter what you do, don't ever, ever give up from the rahmah of your Lord. Don't ever say, I did enough of sins and Allah will not care about me. Ever. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not out there to get us, but He extends His hand day and night to forgive us. Day and night. On the ma'asiyah itself, Allah still will call upon you and He will say to you, O my servant, ask and I will forgive you. Ma'asiyah. I'm committing ma'asiyah. Yet, He will be calling you and I at that situation. Yani subhanAllah. Wallahi, thumma wallahi, if I am the owner of me, I will throw it in Jahannam. But I have hope in Allah that Allah will not even show me Jahannam other than passing the Sirat. And none of us, ya ikhwati fillah, none of you commit sins as much as I committed. None of us ever lose hope in the mercy of Allah and say Allah doesn't care about me. Never. Because He does. And He does. And that's why, ya ikhwati fillah, on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, you and I will wish if we committed so many sayyi'at because of the amount of hasanat that was generated from the sins that we committed. Not the hasanat, but the sins. Allah, Allah, fi tawbah, ya ikhwati fillah. Tawbah. Because wallahi thumma wallahi. Today, our tawbah can be accepted. But when we die, and we wish to just to come back to this dunya, for one tasbih, or one istighfar, just one. Just to say self. Ya Allah, forgive what I did. Just once. And that will not be granted to us. But today, we hear, Alhamdulillah, we can say Astaghfirullah. Let us say Astaghfirullah. Say. And let us have that hope in Allah, that Allah will forgive us. And He will. I guarantee you, Allah will forgive you. Wallahi thumma wallahi. Wallahi thumma wallahi, Allah will forgive you. If you're sincere in your tawbah, and if you really want to come to Allah, come back to your Lord, Allah will forgive you. I guarantee you that. So don't ever lose hope in Allah, and don't ever give up on tawbah.